Alright guys, so today I will show you a config trick that will allow you to perform a perfect Shaiku peak with a single button press. But before we get into the config setup, let me show you what a Shaiku peak actually is. With a Shaiku peak, you can get free intel by peeking around a corner or even secure an easy kill without risking to die. It's a specific way of leaning into a corner without exposing yourself for too long. The first step of a Shaiku peek is to lean into the corner you want to peek. After that, you start to strafe into that corner. Once you got all the intel, you lean into the opposite direction and strafe back into cover. And as an optional last step, you lean into the corner again to perform a second Shaiku peek, or you kill the enemy that you just spotted. When you do the whole process fast enough, then the enemy will hardly be able to see you, and they also have no chance to react. I will now show you how you can automate that in the most optimal way. You will be able to perform as many Shaiku peaks in a row as you want to, and you can also fully control the speed of your peaks. For the setup, you will need 4 subconfigs and 2 buttons that you haven't bound to any other action yet. So start your Zim Manager and load your Rainbow Six Siege config. By the way, I will make a new Rainbow Six Siege config as soon as the Zim works again with a PlayStation 5, which could actually happen in the next few weeks. So don't forget to subscribe to the channel if you don't want to miss that announcement. Now go into your hip bindings and switch into the secondary button bindings. First, I will set up a key with which I can Shaiku lean to the right. I will use the X key for that. What I have to do now is to bind that key to the sprint action. Next, switch into the first subconfig and activate it. Set the activation button to your right Shaiku lean key. So for me, that is once again the X key. Next, change all your subconfig values so that they match your hip config. I already did that in advance. At last, untick the inherit box at the top and scroll down to the walking settings. Bind your right Shaiku key to the right option here. Next, you have to head into the secondary button bindings. At the top, you now have to bind the melee action to your right Shaiku lean key. Also, delete the right Shaiku key from the sprint action. Once it is done, you can switch into the next subconfig. Again, activate the config and bind its activation key to your right Shaiku key. Next, you have to expand the advanced options and set the delay value to 150. After that, you can scroll down to the sensitivity options. Just like before, change all the values here until they match your hip setup. I already did that in advance. At last, untick the inherit box again and change your right walking key to your Shaiku key. Next, let's set up the Shaiku lean into the other direction. The setup is the very same, but this time you will bind your left Shaiku button to the melee action and the other strafe direction. But first, we have to bind our left Shaiku key in the secondary hip bindings. My preferred left Shaiku button is the Y key. Now, as I just said, the setup is the same as before, but we will now bind our left Shaiku key to the opposite leaning and walking key. I will not explain the setup steps a second time and will instead just show you the setup process in the background. If the following is a little bit too fast for you, then you can either use a copy and paste code from the video description or wait for my new config video for Rainbow Six Siege. In that one, I will show the whole Shaiku setup in more detail. Once the setup is complete, you just lean into the direction of the corner you want to Shaiku peek. Start to strafe into the corner and press your new Shaiku button to get back into cover. By quickly switching between your normal movement keys and your new Shaiku buttons, you can now control the speed of your Shaiku peek, so how much you want to peek into the corner. So guys, if you enjoyed the video, hit the like button or maybe even subscribe to this channel to not miss out on any of the upcoming videos. Also, contrary to popular belief, this channel is not an official Zim channel. I run this channel in my free time to bring you guys the latest Zim news and tricks. So if you want to support what I do, then maybe consider to join the YouTube channel membership. Channel members usually get around 1-4 weeks of early access to all new videos. Plus, we also have a nice little Discord to discuss Zim settings and other stuff. But that's about it for this video, guys. Thanks for watching, and I will maybe see you in the next one.